Hello. Today I am going to explain about the transportation problems. So what is transportation problem? Transportation is an operation research technique intended to establish the least cost route of transportation of goods from company's factories to its warehouses located at different places. We know that many materials, finished goods, etc. have to be moved from one place to another for business to take place. Now, transportation is a special type of LPP that involves transportation of goods from supply points to demand points. It involves determination of optimum route to minimize the costs. So here, the main objective is to minimize the costs. In order to solve a transportation problem, we should know about the number of sources, the number of destinations, total quantity available at each source, total quantity required at each destination, cost of transportation of one unit of commodity. Now, how we can formulate the transportation model? Now, here is one table wherein we have three factories F1, F2, F3 and supplies, warehouses ABC, the warehouses and three factories. The total available supply in F1 is S1, F2 factory is S2, in F3 factory is S3. Similarly, the demand of warehouse A is D1, demand of B is D2, demand of C is D3. Now, C1A represents a unit cost of transporting a unit quantity from the factory F1 to the warehouse B. Similarly, C1B represents the unit cost of transportation of from the factory F1 to the warehouse B. So these are all the unit costs of respective transportation, unit transportation cost of from the factories to the respective warehouses. Now these are the supply and these are the demands. Now how we can formulate the LPP problem for this? So here the total cost of transportation, if I am supplying X11 unit to the warehouse A, X12 unit to warehouse B, X13 units to warehouse C. That means my total cost will be X11C1A plus X12C1B plus X13C1B plus again here X21 for A, X22 for B, X23 for C. So like that we can add all the cost of each transportation of each item to each warehouse. So that will give you the total transportation cost. Now what is objective function? Here our objective function is minimize this transportation cost. That is minimize Z is equal to the transportation cost. Now here what are the constraints? We can see the constraints here. Supply is S1 only from the factory S1. That means total transportation or the total units for all these three units must be S1, that is X11 for A, X12 for B, X13 for C, that is X11 plus X12 plus X13 will be equal to S1. Similarly, you have the factory F2, similarly it is X21 plus X22 plus X23 is equal to S2. So these are the supply constraints. Similarly, we have the demand constraints. What is the demand? So maximum demand is D1. So here X11 X plus X21 plus X31 will be equal to D1. So similarly, you can write the demand constraint for the other two warehouses also. So this is how you can formulate the transportation problem into LPP, linear programming problem. Now how to solve the transportation problem? To get the optimum solution, that is to get the minimum transportation cost, here we need to go for two stages or two phases. In the stage 1 or step 1, we need to have the initial basic feasible solution. Next, we need to get the optimum solution for that. So here, for getting the initial basic solution, we have three methods: northwest corner method, lowest cost method, as well as Vogel's transformation method, approximation method. And here also we have two more methods. So one is the modified distribution method, that is MODI method. So here we are going to study MODI method. Now before going for any of the methods, first you need to check whether your supply, total of supply is equal to demand. That is S1 plus S2 plus S3, whether it is equal to D1 plus D2 plus D3. If supply is equal to demand, then you can proceed with your basic feasible solution. Now, if demand is more than supply, so then you need to add a dummy column in the matrix with zero cost. If supply is greater than demand, then add a dummy row in the matrix with zero cost. Now, what is a basic feasible solution? A feasible solution to a transformation problem is said to be a basic feasible solution if it contains not more than m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocations. That means whatever the allocations you are doing, that should be equal to m plus n minus 1, where m is the number of rows, n is the number of columns, or m is the number of factories, n is the number of warehouse efficiencies. So it should be equal to this. Now let me start with the first method, that is northwest corner rule. So here in this method, allocate the maximum feasible quantity to the left uppermost corner cell. Left uppermost corner cell. Here left uppermost corner cell is 4. So before that, just check whether your supply is equal to demand. Here it is, supply is 40 plus 60 plus 50, 150. Demand is 20 plus 30 plus 50 plus 50, that is 150. So the given problem is balanced. Now this is the uppermost left corner. So you allot the minimum of supply and demand. Now the demand is 20 here, supply is 40. So I can allocate only 20 units for this cell. When you allot 20 units, so here the demand for this warehouse is only 20. So it's satisfied with that. So that is why you are not going to allot any more units. Here if the supply is 40, now you have allotted only 20, so 20 is remaining. In the next step, you see the next leftmost corner, this is 6. So here supply is 20, here the demand is 30. So I can allot only 20 units. So allotted 20 units. So here it satisfies with supply. But here the demand is 10 more. That means I need to allot 10 more units to this warehouse again, because it requires 10 more units. In the next step, the next leftmost corner, that is 8. So here the demand is 10, supply is 60. So how much you can allot? You can allot only 10. That means this warehouse is satisfied its demand. So here out of 60, I have allotted 10. So the remaining is 50 here. So that means you can't allot here as well as here and this row. Now the leftmost corner is this one, that is 6. Here how much I can allot? Here the supply is 50, demand is 50. So I am going to allot 50 units over here. So here we have done with the supply as well as the demand. So here only one cell is remaining, 8. So here the supply is also 50, demand is also 50. So I am allotting 50 units over here. So in this method, I have allotted 20 units here, 20 to this, 10 here, 50 here and 50 here. That means here what is 4, 6, 8, 6, 8. So these are the unit cost of transportation. Now how much you are allotted here? 20. So what will be the total cost now? It is 20 units into, for 1 it is 4 rupees. So 20 into 4 plus 6 into 20, 8 into 10 plus 6 into 50 plus 8 into 50. So the total cost, transportation cost in this method, it is 980 rupees. So this is about northwest corner rule. The next method is least cost or matrix minima method. So here among all the matrix elements, select the cell with the least element. If there is a tie, select any one and allot minimum between the respective demand and supply to that cell. That means here you need to see in this table or in this matrix, you need to see the least cost. So least cost is 4. That means 4 is the least cost in this matrix. So you allot first for that one. That is, here how much I can allot? The demand is 20, supply is 40. So I can allot only 20. That means I am not going to allot any more on this warehouse, because demand is 20 as well as I have allotted 20 units. Now in the supply, 20 units remaining. Next again, is Indies remaining 3 into 3 matrix, you see which is the minimum. So here minimum is 6. So I can allot anyone because here we have a time, because 6, 3 entries has 6 here. So you can take randomly anyone. So I am taking this 6. And here I am going to allot, here 20 is the supply remaining, 30 is the demand. So here I am going to allot 20 units. That means this supply part is over. So 10 is remaining over here. Now in the next step, again you have this, anyhow it is over. So in this remaining this, which is the least one, that is again 60. So here how much you can allot? So here 50 is the demand, 60 is the supply. So I can allot 50 over here. So this demand has been satisfied. Then we have the remaining two, that is this one, 8, 7, 7, 8. Okay, because here 10 is remaining. So in this, which is the minimum? Minimum is 7. So I will go with this 7 and I will allot 10 units here. When I allot 10 units over here, it is the remaining is 40. Next we have only two entries, 7 and 8. So first let us go for the minimum 7. So here I will allot 10. So here the remaining is 50. And next we have the 8 is a minimum value, next value. So I am allotting 40 the remaining. So here in this what you need to do is, you need to check the least value in the matrix. And you need to allot the units in the least cost cell. Okay, after doing this, just you get the final matrix, 4 into 20 plus 6 into 20 plus 6 into 50 plus 7 into 10 plus 7 into 10 plus 8 into 40. So the total cost will be 960 here using this method. So in this method, in the least cost method, we need to find out the at each stage we need to find out the minimum value. We need to find out the minimum value in the cell. Once if you are filling that, then you go for the next minimum. If there is a tie, select any one of that. Here we got 666. So select any one and allot as much as units for that particular this one. And here after allotting this, again 6 is the minimum. Again I have allotted 50 units. So 10 is remaining here. Then again you see the next minimum. Once that demand is over, just you put the mark so that this row, sorry, this column, and this column and this column you can't allot. So now the remaining things is only 8, 7 and 8, 7. So in this you see where you can allot. So I have allotted 10 over here. So once 10 is allotted, here you can't allot because it is 20 plus 10 is 30. So already it is over. So only the possibility is over these two. So here what you can do, here 10 is remaining. So you can allot 10. Once you allot 10 here, so here you have the remaining is 40. So here also 40, here also 40. So the remaining 40 units you allot it over here. So like this way, finding the minimum value in each step and allot as much as possible. So that will give you the total cost. So this is how we can compute the basic feasible solution for the transportation problem by using northwest corner rule and least cost method.